فيا سائلا عن منهج الحق يبتغي سلوك طريق القوم حقا ويسعد تأمل هداك الله ما قد نظمته تأمل من قد كان للحق يقصد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, here we are in the last 5 nights of Ramadan, and the month is already finished. And I want to remind you of a hadith that we had mentioned on another occasion, where in it Aisha radiallahu anha, she asks the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if she were to witness Laylatul Qadr, what should she do? قالت عائشة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن وافيت ليلة القدر فما أقول؟ قال قولي اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. She, عائشة رضي الله عنها, asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, Oh Messenger of Allah, if I witness ليلة القدر, what should I supplicate in it? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, you should supplicate by saying, O Allah, you are the most forgiving and you love forgiveness, so forgive me. The ulama deduced the wisdom behind this dua. It's the month of Ramadan. Muslims all around the world are doing all acts of worship, from siyam, fasting, from tasbih, tahmeed, dhikr of Allah, dua, giving to the poor, doing qiyam al-layl, gathering with the Muslims, all these acts of worship. Yet the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answers Aisha's question by saying to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama, the likes of Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen and other than them, they say that seeking forgiveness is from leaving the wajibat and committing sins. Because at the end of the day, no matter how good we are and no matter how strong we try to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will always have shortcomings, because we are slaves, we're insan at the end of the day. We're always going to have shortcomings towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he deserves to be worshipped. That's why we seek forgiveness. Even the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is infallible, who stood up all night to pray qiyam layl, who the Quran came down on him, he used to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this occasion, Sheikh Abdul Razak hafizahullah, the son of Sheikh Abdul Muhsin al-Abbad, hafizahumullah ajma'in, he mentions a very beautiful story that had happened with him on a 27th night, where he and his father and grandfather, they came out to go to head towards Masjid al-Nabawi to pray Salah on the 27th night for Taraweeh. So the Shaykh hafizahullah mentions, and he says that when I came out to head to my car, he said I saw a car that was a bit far away from us, but yet had loud music. And he says, mind you, this is the 27th night. So he said, I decided to walk to the car and advise them. So he said, when I went to them, I saw that there were a bunch of youth. He said, look, if you're not going to appreciate this night, and if you're not going to pray and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this night, the least you could do is put down this loud music and don't harm the Muslims. So then when they put down the music before he left, he hafizahullah told them about this hadith and told them about the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. And he said, repeat this dua again and again. Keep it in your tongue. And then he looked at the one that was beside him on the passenger seat, and he said, did you memorize the dua that I just said? He said, yes. And then he said, okay, repeat it. He tried to repeat it, he couldn't. The Shaykh said, I repeated it twice, three times, till he memorized it, till he was able to repeat it fully. When he repeated it fully, the Shaykh said, keep this dua on your tongue. Keep this dua on your tongue. He said, this is the least you can do. And then he left them. He then mentions, he said, years down the road, maybe 5-4 years later, he says, I was on a da'wah trip in one of the da'wah centers in the Mamlaka. And he says, then I met those who are working there. And then it was Salah time. He said, in Salah time, he said, this young youth came beside me who was practicing and had his beard and the khair looked in his face. He came and he said, sat down beside me and passed his salams. And then he told me, do you remember the story of so-and-so at that time? He said, the sheikh said, yes, I remember. He said, I was one of the youth that was sitting in that car. He said, that dua, when that night you taught us, he said, I kept that dua on my tongue. So much so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened up my heart. Sharha sadri lil-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened his heart to guidance and Allah guided him. Allah guided him with this dua. And he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took all this love that I had for the music and the shahawat, he took it out of me. And as you see my situation right now, walillahi alhamd. Therefore, ya ibadallah, you never know when Laylatul Qadr is coming in. Keep this dua in your tongue. And the best time and best place to keep this dua in your tongue is when you're doing sujood, whether it's Qiyam al-Layl or whether in your regular salawat. Keep this dua in your tongue. Repeat it again and again in your sujood, in the middle of the night. If you're sitting down, whatever you're doing, keep this dua in your tongue. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to witness this night and to be from amongst those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives. Allahumma innaka afuwwun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Allahumma innaka afuwwun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Allahumma taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami'ul 'alim wa tub 'alayna innaka anta at-tawwabur rahim. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.